anything else. It has some importance. Osmolarity in the kidney medulla, Jan Pratham. Okay. Anything else? There are so many things for the osmolarity. Why uric acid only? But of course, it play important role. Sir, in renal system, it help in maintaining osmolarity. Okay. Apart from osmolarity, most important. Yes, Disha Agrawal. It is a antioxidant. This is the very important thing. If somebody is asking to you, okay, what is the role of physiological role of uric acid? First thing you have to tell like that antioxidant. For the osmolarity and all, there are so many things, so many solutes are there. But suppose, as you know, the terminal enzyme for the vitamin C synthesis in our body is basically deficient. We don't have the terminal enzyme so that we can't form the vitamin C in our body. In that scenario, even you are not taking vitamin C from outside, then this uric acid will play important role as an antioxidant. So nature ne aisa hame diya hai ki hamare paas agar vitamin C nahi bhi hai, nahi hai, to up to some extent we can have antioxidant property with the help of that uric acid. So koi bhi examiner agar aapse puchta hai pehla question like the what is the physiological role of uric acid? So it is a natural antioxidant. Okay, but of course, if it is more in amount, if it increases in more in the serum, definitely it leads to some manifestation like stone formation in urinary tract or maybe the tophi formation due to the crystal formation by the help of crystal formation like the monosodium urate crystals. So let's start with a case. This case is a 1 minute. This case is a 40-year-old man came to the chief complaint of 40-year-old man come with the chief complaint of pain in the great toe. He gave history of consuming alcohol the previous day, and on examination, doctors found like that the metatarsophalangeal joint of the right first toe was worn, tender, and the patient wins with pain on pressing the first toe. उसको वार्म है, टेंडर है, रेड है और उसे टेस्ट करने पे उसको पेन फील हो रहा है. एट द सेम टाइम एक्सरे ऑफ द राइट फुट वाज एडवाइस एंड ब्लड सैंपल वाज कलेक्टेड एंड सेंट फॉर द सीरम यूरिक एसिड लेवल. सो विद दिस केस यू डेफिनेटली मस्ट हैव सम साइट लाइक द इनसाइट लाइक दैट डेफिनेटली द पेशेंट हैविंग some kind of problem associated with the increased uric acid or decreased uric acid. Yes, some problem with the uric acid. That's why doctor saying uric acid for the estimation. Okay, so today class basically the as you already come across with like the purine synthesis degradation, or simply we can say the metabolism, nucleotide metabolism. So I will not cover much about that cycle ki kya metabolism ke each step, but definitely I will give you some overview of purine synthesis and degradation, because this purine synthesis and its degradation only leads to the uric acid formation. So definitely I will give some overview, but I know you all are well versed with this thing. Here we will discuss about the cause of the hyperuricemia and hypouricemia. किस कंडीशन में यूरिक एसिड ज्यादा होगा और कम होगा, डेफिनेटली वी विल डिस्कस हियर एंड वी विल डिस्कस द कॉजेस एंड व्हाट इज द बायोकेमिकल बेसिस हाउ इट लीड्स टू द इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज लेवल ऑफ द यूरिक एसिड. एंड फाइनली इन दिस टुडे प्रैक्टिकल ब्रीफिंग हियर विल डिस्कस द प्रिंसिपल बिहाइंड द मेथड ऑफ एस्टिमेशन ऑफ यूरिक एसिड. कौन कौन से मेथड यूज होते हैं यूरिक एसिड के एस्टिमेशन में और उन मेथड का प्रिंसिपल क्या है. सो बाय द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन यू शुड एबल टू आंसर व्हाट आर द कॉजेज ऑफ द हाइपर यूरिसीमिया, हाइपो यूरिसीमिया एंड द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द टेस्ट विच यूज फॉर द यूरिक एसिड एस्टिमेशन. ओके, ठीक है. सो दिस इज यूरिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ यूरिक एसिड. You know the uric acid is dibasic or diprotic acid, basically diprotic acid. It has the two pKa. Okay. One is the 5.57 and two is the 10.3. Some books mention 9.8 also. So not to worry about it. It is okay. Book to book variation for the second pKa two is there. But I have taken from this one standard book, that is Tate's Biochemistry. So there are two pKa. One is the 5.57 and second is the 10.3. And the chemical name of this uric acid is 2,6-8-trioxypurine, because basically it is derived from the degradation product of the purine only. The chemical, as we common name use, is the uric acid, but it is a 2,6-8-trioxypurine. And you know the final degradation product of the purine catabolism. Okay, I will tell you the importance of the diprotic nature. 2 pKa value, why to put, how this 2 pKa value are important, pKa 5.57 and 10.3 in the coming slides. Just go through this protein de novo synthesis as already covered. These are the things, I think, the what are the this C4, C5 and N7 came from the glycine. I don't want to tell this thing. I'm just giving you overview. Whereas the C6, in the when you're talking about the purine ring structure, C6 come from the CO2, N1 come from aspartate, whereas N2, C2 come from the N10 formyl tetrahydrofolate glutamine, and C8 from the N10 formyl tetrahydrofolate, whereas N9 from the ribose phosphate. So this is the overview of the purine synthesis. As you know, and this is the salvage pathway. So salvage pathway, this hypoxanthine will convert into the inosine monophosphate. Similarly, guanine will convert into the guanine monophosphate and adenine adenine. Under the presence of hypoxanthine guanine phosphoribosyl transferase, again for the guanine to GMP conversion, the same enzyme is responsible. But for the adenine to AMP conversion, adenine phosphoribosyl transferase is there. So this basically the problem with the uric acid metabolism, increased uric acid in the blood, is somewhere related to this enzyme only. That's why I am giving you a overview. This is just, you know, the salvage pathway. I will tell you where the enzyme defect leads to the increased uric acid formation. So this is protein degradation pathway. This finally, this GMP AMP will convert into the uric acid. This thing is already covered. Now come to the uric acid excretion. See, uric acid, basically uric acid, 70% of the uric acid is excreted by the kidney. Only report a small amount, thoda amount bolenge, or you can say the 30% in the GI tract. In 70%, when you're talking about the renal handling of uric acid, this among the 70%, the freely filtered by the glomerulus. That means the glomerulus se ye sare filtered ho jate hain, aur wahan pe reabsorption in the PCT mein inka 100% reabsorption hota hai. At the same time, they also secreted in a small amount in the distal portion of the PCT, and reabsorption also takes place in the distal collecting duct. So this is how the uric acid excretion as well as the secretion taking place. These are the site where the importance of this site, I mean the renal threshold, is very important to know the where it is secreted and where it is reabsorbed. Because at that particular site, if anything is a tissue injury or insult or any tubular damage is there in the kidney, that will lead to either increased level or decreased level. It depends on that scenario. So that's why the renal handling of the uric acid very important. 1 minute. Okay. Next, serum uric acid. When you're talking about, we should know the normal level. Normal level in the male and female. So that what we call the reference interval. In the female, it is 2.5 to 5.6 milligram per deciliter. Where in male, it is 3.1 to 7 milligram per deciliter. Why it is less in the female? Anybody can, would you like to answer? Anybody? Female mein ek kam kyun hota hai as compared to male? क्वेश्चन बॉक्स में मैं हूं, आप बताओ इसका आंसर. लेस मसल मास. ओके, एनीथिंग एल्स? लेस मसल, मोर फैट ड्यू टू एस्ट्रोजन. द आंसर इज सिंपल, लेस मसल मोर फैट और लेस बॉडी वाटर यू कैन से. That is also basically body water is only play important role. Muscle mass and uric acid, body water, whatever the dilutional effect, that also, because when you are measuring, that means you are measuring. Dilutional effect play important role. That's why the uric acid is less. Less water is there, it is. Of course, muscle will be less, the whatever the cells will be there, cell will form the everything. So less number of the cell, less number of the cell, the less degradation, the less amount of the. Okay. Body urate pool, again we're talking about the body urate pool. Male is 1200 milligram, whereas the female is the 600. Exist in the ionized form. When this uric acid and monosodium urate, again it is this, there are the two form of the uric acid presentation in our body. So uric acid is the less soluble as compared to the monosodium urate. It is more soluble, and this is one of the reason when this uric acid goes into the kidney after filtration and all, when it is passed through the urine in the distal part of the kidney, you know the acidification takes place in the distal part of the kidney. So wahan pe acidification hota hai na, to wo agar 5.5 se niche ho gaya, so it will become the less soluble, and that's why uric acid crystal will be there, and that is the reason for the formation of the stone. So whenever a stone will be formed, that stone will for the whenever the stone will be formed, that stone will be made up of uric acid. But when there is the alkalinization of the system, suppose hum urine ko alkalinize kar rahe hain, so what will happen? The pH will go more than 5.5, is something towards the 10-9, jo ki uska dusra pKa value hai. In that scenario, uric acid will exist in form monosodium urate form. That is more soluble form. So there are two forms. Most of the time it is exist in the ionized form. Okay. But whenever it will come into the urine, due to the acidification of the urine, it will convert into the unionized form, that is the uric acid form, and wahi region hota hai wahan pe urinary stone banne ka, jo ki uric acid ka stone banta hai. Theek hai, I think abhi clear ho gaya. So and plasma is jab concentration more than 6.8, why not more than 6.8? Actually, the after 7 or 6.8 mg per deciliter, uric acid will get saturated. So whatever the monosodium urate will be, crystal will be formed, and this monosodium urate crystal will deposited in the different bony part, like the synovial fluid may deposition ho jayega, ya fir first metatarsal joint ke pass may deposition ho jayega. So ye kabhi bhi 6.8 ya 7 se jyada nahi ho sakta, बिकॉज इसके बाद फिर सेचुरेशन हो जाता है, वो यूरिक एसिड फॉर्म में रहेगा ही नहीं, मोनोसोडियम फॉर्म के रूप में, यूरेट के फॉर्म में वो डिपोजिटेड हो जाएगा, डिपोजिशन. सो दिस इज अ इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट, यू विल नॉट गेट मोर देन 6.8, दिस इज द हाईएस्ट वैल्यू. आफ्टर दैट देयर विल बी द सेचुरेशन, एंड दिस सेचुरेशन लीड टू द एक्युमुलेशन ऑफ द मोनोसोडियम यूरेट इन फॉर्म ऑफ ए क्रिस्टल. इसको टोफाई बोलते हैं, और बेसिकली गाउट में टोफाई होता है, वो हम आगे वो इसका मेकानिज्म ये. Okay, although I will take question. how dilutional effect play role in it. I will say how dilutional effect play role in uric acid in the less body water. I told you female have less body water. Okay, so if it is less body water, whatever you are estimating, definitely everything will be less, blood volume, everything. That the liquid part is less in the female, so definitely if it is less, then less amount of the uric acid will be available there. Okay, or the answer that means the muscle part is the same. Answer is muscle part and fat, muscle is less or fat is more is the same, and this leads to less body water. So fat jada hota hai, less body water hota hai, dono. Okay Abhishek, theek hai. So ionized form or how it is converted into this after saturation of the plasma, it exists in the monosodium urate form. So if it is the urate form, it's passed to the urine. So urine form हो जाएगा. अगर तो phi में जाना हुआ, इधर से आप देख सकते हो. तो ये basically monosodium urate form में ये तो phi में convert हो जाए. So if somebody is asking if the uric, why if the stone is formed, then stone for the uric acid, but why not monosodium urate stone is formed? It is not possible because in urine there will be the acidification, and this acidification leads to a less soluble uric acid. Wo uric acid form mein hi rahega, unionized form mein rahega, aur wo jaake apna stone banayega. Lekin agar amount zyada hoga uric acid ka, then definitely after certain limit it will get saturated, and because of this saturation it will convert into the monosodium urate, and it will get accumulated in the connective tissue like joint and all. Okay, next is the hypouricemia. When urate level is less than 2 mg per deciliter, that is hum bolte hain. अभी कब हो सकता है, कोई लीवर में प्रॉब्लम हो, या जेंथिन ऑक्सीडेज वनली कन्वर्ट करता है उसको जेंथिन टू यूरिक एसिड में, तो उसकी डिफिशियंसी से भी हो सकता है. कुछ ड्रग्स है लाइक द 6 मर्कप्टोप्यूर, यस, सम ड्रग्स लाइक द 6 मर्कप्टोप्यूरिन इज बेसिकली 6 mercaptopurine get metabolized and in presence of the hypoxanthin guanine phosphoribosyl transferase, and this has the inhibitory feedback inhibition on the phosphoribosyl synthesis. Even it has the inhibitory effect on the IMP. So this after all leads to the decreased level of the uric acid, and it increases. So these are the causes for the decreased production. Okay, it can be like that. The increased excretion bhi ho sakta hai. And that increase excretion, you just have to remember some name like the congenital disorder. You need to go through like this. What is Fanconi syndrome and all? It is beyond the scope here, because when you go with the final year, then you will read Fanconi syndrome. Basically, it is a problem in the proximal distal tubules where whatever the reabsorption of the bicarbonate, this uric acid will not take place, so this leads to the more amount of the uric acid will pass through the kidney in the urine, so this leads to the hypouricemia. Although it is not required, but just your naam isse tum yaad rakho ki Fanconi syndrome ho sakta hai, ya maybe due to the some uricosuric drug like the probenecid hota hai uricosuric drug, or some other drugs like contrast agent which basically we use in case of like CT scan or CECT we will do. So we used to give a contrast agent so that wherever this agent will go, whatever the artery or veins will be there, this agent will go there, and we will able to diagnose what is the pathology. Jahan jahan pe blood ka requirement hota hai, wahan wahan contrast jayega, to wo hum ek investigation mein use karte hain, or that will lead to the decreased reabsorption, ultimately hypouricemia. But some uricosuric drug also, you just remember name, even it is not required also. Probenecid is the one name, and other is like high dose of the salicylate. Basically, what happened? If you give the low dose of salicylate, then it inhibit reabsorption. It inhibit the excretion if you give the low dose. Okay, but if you will give the high dose, it has the inhibitory effect on both reabsorption, absorption as well as the secretion. But it has pronounced effect in reabsorption. So net effect is the uricosaric. Matlab reabsorption or secretion दोनों को inhibit करता है high dose of salicylate, लेकिन reabsorption को ज्यादा inhibit करता है, इसलिए ultimately हमारा जो effect होता है वो uricosaric होता है, urine में uric acid आता है, excretion थोड़ा ज्यादा, ठीक है? So this leads to the high dose. Although it is not required, it's the high level of thing like that. High dose of the salicylate, low dose of salicylate. I just told you that if you want, forget about the salicylate, you just remember Provencin is the one drug which is the uricosaric drug. High dose of salicylate, low dose of salicylate, you can give. Low dose of salicylate uricosaric नहीं होता है, लेकिन high dose क्यों होता है? मैंने बता दिया. Because वो absorption को ज़्यादा inhibit करता है as compared to the secretion. तो जितना absorb नहीं होता, ज़्यादा secrete हो जाता है, तो uricosaric को. Okay. Next, hyperuricemia. When serum uric acid level is more than 7 milligram per deciliter in male, and if it is more than 6 milligram in female. So again, it is divided into the increased production. ये either increased production से हो सकता है या decreased excretion से हो सकता है. अगर ज़्यादा production हो रहा है, then again it is divided into the primary and secondary. Primary that means the idiopathic. We don't know. या primary में कोई enzyme deficiency भी आ सकता है. Secondly, due to the excess breakdown of the cell, ya fir turnover cell ka badh jana, in that scenario you will get the excess breakdown hoga, purine metabolism hoga, excess purine breakdown hoga, to of course usme uric acid hi banega, so that will be the secondary causes. Okay, so because of the certain level of any chemotherapy or radiation, so what will happen in that scenario? There will be the destruction of the cell. And this destruction of the cell leads to the nothing but the degradation of the purine. And purine ka degradation ho to uric acid. So that are the secondary causes. Okay. Or primary mein koi enzyme deficiency ho sakta hai ya kuch nahi pata hai, that is idiopathic. These are problem. Similarly, in the decreased excretion, again primary and secondary is like that only. If it is idiopathic, then primary, it's secondary. So this is the table, you can remember. Primary idiopathic ho sakta hai, or when you talking about the hereditary metabolic disorder like HGPRP, जो solvent pathway हमने देखा था, उसकी deficiency से हो गया, then it can lead to the accumulation of the uric acid. Similarly, PRP and glycogen storage disorder. Why in glycogen storage disorder? Would you like to answer anybody? These are, this thing are okay. You know this, this is associated with the primary. How glycogen storage one jerk disease leads to hyperuricemia? Question box mein bolo likho. Increased glucose 6 phosphate stimulate HMP pathway. Okay, Disha. Aur ye kya hoga? Ribosyl 5 phosphate banayega, fir N-acetyl. Okay, this is one reason. Agree. Another region, can you tell me? Lactic acidosis. How lactic acidosis leads to hyperuricemia? Karthik Swami, up to some extent you are right, but how it is? Lactic acidosis kaise karega? Yes, compete Vaibhav Kalra. Compete with the excretion of urea, because the transporters in the tubules are the almost both are same, so same for so it will compete, and usse kya hoga, iska level badh jayega. Bilkul sahi. Okay, okay, very nice Batul Nadeem. Okay, so similarly, when you talking about the secondary causes of increased production, प्यूरिन रिच डाइट ले रहे हैं तब हो सकता है। इंक्रीज टर्नओवर हो गया, इंक्रीज टर्नओवर कब होगा, कोई सेल प्रोलिफरेट कर रहा है, बहुत सारे सेल बन रहे हैं, उसमें क्या किसमें बनते हैं, मैलिग्नेंसी में बनते हैं, कैंसर में ऐसे होता है। ठीक है, अगर कैंसरस सेल अब बन गए, तो अगर हम कैंसरस सेल बन गए उसको हम मारते हैं कैसे, हाउ विल किल द कैंसरस सेल, दैट इज केमोथेरेपी, वी विल इंट्रोड्यूस द केमोथेरेपेटिक ड्रग एंड दिस केमोथेरेपेटिक ड्रग हैज अ साइटोटॉक्सिक एक्शन, वो सेल्स को मार देते हैं और डिग्रेड कर देते हैं प्यूरिन, तो वहां भी यूरिक एसिड बढ़ जाएगा। सिमिलरली रेडियोथेरेपी इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द वे टू किल द सेल्स। एंड सोरियसिस, सोरियसिस इज ए स्किन मैनिफेस्टेशन, इज ए काइंड ऑफ डर्मेटोलॉजिकल डिजीज, और उसमें क्या होता है कि जो स्किन जो भी हो एपिडर्मिस टर्न ओवर बढ़ जाता है। नॉर्मली व्हाट हैपन इन आवर एपिडर्मिस इट लाइक द जो भी कैरेटिनोसाइट्स होते हैं, कैरेटिनोसाइट्स नॉर्मली इंक्रीज करते हैं, मतलब व्हाट एवर द बेसल कैरेटिनोसाइट्स इट विल कम टू द सर्फेस आफ्टर 30 डेज, उसको 30 दिन लगते हैं बेसल कैरेटिनोसाइट्स और एपिथेलियल सेल को उसको सर्फेस में आने पे। लेकिन जो जिस पेशेंट को सोरियासिस है हार्डली इट विल टेक 4 डेज, तो सी हाउ दिस टर्नओवर इंक्रीजेस, टर्नओवर नंबर जिसको 30 दिन लगते थे इस डिजीज कंडीशन में 4 डेज लगते हैं, और वो सेल्स डेफिनेटली वो डिन्यूड हो जाते हैं, वो डिन्यूडेशन में चले जाते हैं, वो सेल मर भी जाते हैं। तो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट किलिंग ऑफ दैट सेल और ओवर प्रोडक्शन और इंक्रीज टर्नओवर नंबर दिस लीड्स टू यूरिक एसिड फॉर्मेशन। प्रीक्लैम्पसिया इज ए गायनिक कंडीशन, ओबीजी ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव गायनिक कंडीशन, बेसिकली इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव कंडीशन characterized by the increased BP and proteinuria. In that scenario also there will be the destruction of the placenta. बहुत ज्यादा placental cells वहाँ बन जाते हैं, उनका destruction भी होता है। So either turnover बढ़ गया या उनका destruction भी हुआ, अगर बढ़ेगा तो destruction भी होगा, तो uric acid बन जाएगा। And how alcohol? Can anybody tell alcohol कैसे करता है? How it is, it increases the uric acid. एक मिनट क्वेश्चन बॉक्स में आ रहा हूँ। Yes. आशीष भास्कर, hypoxanthin guanine phosphoribosyl transferase man, HGPRT का फुल फॉर्म पूछ रहा है। ये तो क्लास में हुआ होगा। Anyway. Beer is purin rich. Beer is purin rich. Okay. Or beer is purin rich. This is okay. Yeah, I'm not denying this. ये भी एक one of the reason है. Or increase NADH formation. This is the Abhishek Singh what you are telling. NADH बन जाएगा. Which leads to what? Conversion of the monosodium urate to uric acid. And this leads to the hyperuricemia. Okay. Very nice. Okay, hyperuricemia decrease excretion. It can be say secondary to the decrease excretion also. So primary again idiopathic if you don't know causes, and secondary if the renal disease is there, then also. And organic acid. What we talk about that the organic acid like lactate ho gaya, acetoacetate ho gaya. So ye compete karenge. Aur uske saath. This thing we already covered. So next important thing is very important clinical scenario, what we call is the Les-Nyhan syndrome. It is a X-linked recessive disorder, and here is the complete deficiency of SGPRT. And I hope you know SGPRT. Somebody is asking is the full form of SGPRT. Hyperuricemia. This is the characterized by uric acid badh jayega and self-destructive behavior. खुद को ही काटपीट करने लगता है, सी देयर दिस बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सेल्फ म्यूटिलेटिंग बिहेवियर इज जस्ट बाय बिकॉज ऑफ द बाइट एंड ऑल दिस लीजन आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द हैंड, एंड डेफिनेटली बिकॉज ऑफ द दिस यूरिक एसिड एंड प्रोटीन सो प्यूरिन डिग्रेडेशन इज ऑल्सो इफेक्ट द लाइक द न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर इन द ब्रेन एंड दैट्स वाई इट लीड्स टू द मेंटल रिटार्डेशन. Okay, so these are the classical feature like that hyperuricemia, self destructive behavior, mental retardation, even patient can present with the urinary stone. What kind of urinary stone? It is the uric acid stone. So pathogenesis, again the salvage pathway, because of the deficiency of this enzyme, increased breakdown of the purine, resulting increased de novo synthesis also. So banega breakdown of a banega breakdown. So this will lead to an increased level of the uric acid. And you know the brain is largely dependent on the this salvage pathway. So yeah, brain वहां पे brain function भी compromise होंगे तो mental retardation that is the next is the gout. Gout is a metabolic disease with the increased body urate pool and hyperuricemia. That means the body urate pool जो भी है urate उसमें बढ़ जाएगा. अब here we are talking about that that is beyond than the saturation limit. अब saturation limit 6.8 तक की थी, उससे ज्यादा हो रहा है तो वट एवर द यूरिक एसिड विल कन्वर्ट इन टू द मोनोसोडियम क्रिस्टल और वो क्रिस्टल बनेंगे कहाँ पे जहाँ कनेक्टिव टिश्यू लाइक द सैलोवियन सैनोवियल फ्लूइड के आसपास बनेंगे या फिर द पस मेटाटर्स टेनेंजियल में बनेंगे. डिपोजिशन ऑफ दिस मोनोसोडियम यूरेट क्रिस्टल इन द ज्वाइंट एंड द कनेक्टिव टिश्यू इज नथिंग बट द टोफाई जिससे बोलते हैं. और मिडिल एज टू एल्डरली वुमेन मोस्ट कॉमनली अफेक्टेड episode it can be acute or chronic. Okay, so because of this deformity and whatever the swelling and all because secondary to this tophi, presentation can be both either it is chronic or acute. But it is very important one thing I would like to add here. If suppose a patient present with the chronic episode, that means it is not necessary that uric acid will be increased. Even the normal uric acid can be presented as the acute condition. Acute condition mein normal uric acid bhi ho sakta hai aur gout, acute gout ho sakta hai. That means acute gout can be presented with the normal uric acid level. But when we are talking about the chronic gout, there must should be the elevated level of the uric acid. Because acute gout, what happened? Somebody is predisposed to like a or you can say the on the verge of the more level of uric acid, and he consumed certain level of alcohol last night and all. So that can precipitate in one day only there will be the acute condition where wo kya ho jayega uska jahan bhi tophi wagera hai wahan pe inflammation ho jayega, redness ho jayegi. So that can be acute presentation. In that scenario it is not necessary that patient must have the increased level of the uric acid. Okay, level bada bhi ho sakta hai, kam bhi ho sakta hai. It can be more or less, but in case of the chronic you will get the increased level of the uric acid. So this is the one of different distinguished feature between the acute and the chronic acute and chronic gout. And whatever the manifestation, if the somebody has the joint problem and then it is called the arthritis. Arthritis is a layman term. It's like the anything. If the erosion of the your joint region of the or any accumulation or anything else which leads to immobility of the joints or pain leads a condition which result into the painful joint movement, then it is called arthritis. So here the first metatarsophalangeal joint most commonly involved. And see here you can see the picture, the swollen inflamed joints with the uric acid crystal is there. And in radiology this finding is called, basically what happened in the long cases there will be the removal of the soft tissue from this side, or isko bolte hain martel sign, martel, martel sign is a radiological finding. When you will get the x-ray you will see the soft disappearance of the soft tissue inner border of this toe, proximal joint of this toe. So this is basically the martel joint. It is not required, but if you want to write you can write it. Aage tumhe milega ye sab questions apne second third year fourth year mein jaoge. So when you will do the orthosynthesis, so joint aspiration, probably you will take the aspirate from this joint and to look for the whatever the crystal form. And the nature of this crystal is negative bifringent crystal. when you see through the plain polarized light, we found negatively bifringent crystal. Ye word important hai, negatively bifringent crystal, not positively. If it is positive, then it's something else. That's why I'm telling you, you should remember these two terminology, negatively bifringent crystals. So this is the only picture of the negatively bifringent crystals. So serum urate level may be normal during acute attack, I told you. अगर ये renal insufficiency में deposition होता है तो क्या करेगा? Urate nephrolithiasis करेगा. Now urate nephrolithiasis is nothing but the urate stone formation is will be there. So how will we manage the cord? Okay. So of course सारे कुछ purine से हो रहा है तो you will give the low purine diet. Then alcohol can precipitate the symptoms or can precipitate. So it leads. So you have to decrease the alcohol consumption. Decrease consumption of the fructose containing food. Okay. Acute attacks like the acute attacks. How you will treat the acute attacks? In that, the treatment of choice is NSAID, non-steroid anti-inflammatory disease. Then colchicine and glucocorticoid. Then as the these are the mainstay treatment. Or for the acute attack, ठीक है? But acute attack में हम allopurinol नहीं देते हैं, वो हमेशा chronic के लिए होता है। जो अभी अभी biochemistry के point of view से आपने आपको याद होगा, if it is a gout, then you can give the allopurinol, not like that. If it is an acute gout, you have to give NSAID, colchicine and glucocorticoid. NSAID nothing but is क्या करेगा? Inflammation को कम करेगा, anti-inflammatory है, तो inflammation को कम करेगा और पेन को भी कम करेगा, प्रोस्टाग्लैंडिन को इनहिबिट करता है. कोल्चिसिन जो माइग्रेशन होता है न्यूट्रोफिल का, तो माइग्रेशन को ही रोक देता है. सो अभी इन्फ्लेमेशन इज अ बिग टर्म, यू विल रीड इन द सेकंड ईयर, बट एज ऑफ नाउ यू नो दैट इट्स जस्ट प्रिवेंट द माइग्रेशन ऑफ द न्यूट्रोफिल, एंड बाय प्रिवेंटिंग द माइग्रेशन ऑफ न्यूट्रोफिल इट बेसिकली प्रिवेंटिंग द इन्फ्लेमेशन. और ग्लूटोकॉर्टिकॉइड्स हैज द सेम एंटी इन्फ्लेमेटरी एक्शन. So some chronic cases में you can give the uricosuric drugs, like uricosuric मैंने बोला था, probenecid. ये uricosuric का expression कहलाता है. Probenecid दे सकते हैं, allopurinol यहाँ देख सकते हैं, fibrostat is a new drug we are using 40 mg, इसको देते हैं. अगर किसी को पता होगा, किसी घर में किसी को थोड़ा बहुत uric acid ज्यादा होगा तो ये दवाएं वो खा रहे हैं, fibrostat ये आजकल ही देते हैं. Respuricase is a recombinant uricase. You know the uricase will convert uric acid to allantoin. We don't have uricase, primates don't have uricase. So हमारे पास uric acid ही रहता है. लेकिन if you will provide this recombinant uricase, nothing but the respuricase, it will convert into allantoin and allantoin will possible. So you can see allopurinol, which is the drug of choice for the chronic gout, and this is structurally analog of the hypoxanthine. You can see the structure of hypoxanthine and allopurinol almost looks similar. And inhibition, this inhibit the xanthine oxidase, and you have read already like that it is suicide as a example of the suicide inhibitor. Xanthine oxidase convert allopurinol to oxypurinol. So how this allopurinol metabolize in the inside body, once you give it will inhibit this xanthine oxidase and there will be no formation of the uric acid. Next important thing is the pseudo gout. Pseudo gout is nothing but the calcium pyrophosphate deposition disease. We otherwise we also called it a calcium pyrophosphate deposition disease. More than 70% have the pre-existing joint diseases, and this here, if you want to remember, you can remember the mutation is the ANKS gene. If you don't want to remember, it's okay. It is not required up to your level. But this is a kind pseudo gout. This you should know, like that it is due to the calcium pyrophosphate deposition disease, and this is mainly deposited in the knee. And this third thing is important. Here you will get positive bifringent crystals. Negative bifringent crystal is the characteristic feature of the gout. there is a positive bifurcation crystal is the characteristic feature of the pseudogout. Bas pseudogout yahan rakhne ka mera bas yahi maqsad tha. No need to remember what is the mutation and all. It is not required. This thing you remember, calcium pyrophosphate deposition se hota hai. Unke paas pre-existing joint disease koi hoga. And knee joint is mainly involved hota hai isme. And here, if you will pass through the plane polarized light, you will get positive bifringing crystals, unlike to the gout where negative. So come to the today practical, or what are the method, or even we are not doing practical as of now, but this is the briefing only. When you will do, if this whatever this condition will, once you are allowed to come in the physical class will be, then you will come to know this. So method of estimation in enzymatic method, basically we are using the uricase enzyme. In presence of the uricase, this uric acid convert into the allantoin, you know, and there is the formation of the H2O. So if you will talk about the how can you quantitate this by this method, so you know the direct spectroscopic measurement, or you can say the absorbance in the UV range of uric acid is 293 nanometer. So if you will do this spectroscopic measurement, if this decrease in the amount of the decrease in the absorbance is leads to the, it's nothing but the indirectly refers to decrease amount of uric acid. Jitna decrease hoga utna uric acid yahan kam, to isse hum usko quantitate kar lete hain. So this is the one reaction. If you want to couple this reaction with the other by adding some other compound, so what you can do, this is the H2O2 is formed. This as you can do, this H2O2 react with 3,5-chloro(2)-hydroxybenzene(sulfonic acid) and 2-aminobenzoate, and this form a red violet quinone amine compound. Red violet quinone amine compound, which we have to measure in 520. So amount of the this red violet compound, jitna ye banega, utni iski activity. Because utna uric acid convert hoga H2O2 se, agar utna H2O2 aayega, wo isse combine karega molecule se. This is a simple thing. So if you want to quantitate, you can quantitate with the help of this single reaction, above single reaction only. And if you want to couple with the other reaction to form a red precipitate, you can do this also. In the first one, you have to measure in 293 spectroscopic measurement, 293 nanometer, because this is for the uric acid. And if you will couple with the other reaction, then you have to measure 520, because this is the for the quinone amine compound. So this is the directly proportional, this is the inversely proportional. Next, what you supposed to do, or you're going to do once this lockdown will get over and the classes will start, lockdown to over hoi gaya. So method of estimation is non-enzymatic method. Wo enzymatic method tha, non-enzymatic. There is Karawe method isko bolte hain. Here the phosphotungstic acid will react with the uric acid under the presence of the alkaline medium, and it will convert into the allantoin and tungstic group. Or basically we are taking reading at 650, which is for the tungsten. So jitna tungsten blue bana, utna uric acid hai. Direct relation. Whatever the absorbance you will get, that will directly correlate with the uric acid. So this is protocol. What we have to do, take 5.4 ml of tungstic acid, add 0.6 ml of serum low. Ye total ho gaya 6 ml, then centrifuge at 4000 rpm for 5 minutes, and then you have to take the 3 ml of this filtrate. Okay, 3 ml filtrate ko lena hai. And now this 3 ml filtrate, you will take that 3 test tube, test standard and blank. In taste, this is the only serum, it's kind of serum. So you have to take the 3 ml of this in the test tube. Then in the standard, you have to take the 3 ml of the working standard, that is 1 mg/cent. Then add 3 ml of distilled water in the blank. Then 1 ml of the 1 ml of the sodium carbonate will. You are going to add 1 ml of the sodium carbonate in all three test tube, like test, standard, or blank, followed by addition of phosphotungstic acid. Same 1 ml of the phosphotungstic acid in all three. Then you have to measure it 650 after 10 minutes. 10 minutes उसको mix करके छोड़ दो. उसके बाद तुम 650 nanometer measure करो. तो जितना तुम्हें color मिल रहा है, उतना OD आता है, उतना उसका relation. How we will calculate? First tell me what is dilution factor here. बहुत लोगों को प्रॉब्लम है इस चीज में. कितना हमने डाइल्यूट किया है आप बताओ क्वेश्चन बॉक्स में. सीरम को कितना डाइल्यूट किया है. आकाश दंडोटिया इज आस्किंग व्हाई मेटा डॉर्सोफेरिंजियल जॉइंट फर्स्ट वन. सी दिस इज द फर्स्ट व्हाई इन्वॉल्व. आई डोंट नो बट एक्चुअली इट इज नॉट क्लियर कि व्हाई फर्स्ट है. बट यस why periphery joint is involved because there will the more formation of the tophi. This tophi is more favorable in peripheral region because of the cold extremity. Extremity cold hoti hai isliye wahan pe hota hai akash dandotiya. But why first is preferred, this is just actually it is not clear anywhere. Second maybe to periphery ho sakta hai. First is wider, but metatarsophalangeal is the peripherally is cold, that's why it's favorable for the crystal formation. Okay, kitna dilution hai koi batao. To kitna dilution hai, dilution kitna hai. PPF kitna diluted hai ye batao. PFF, that is the filtrate, how much it is diluted. See, I have taken 5.4 ml tungstic acid, 0.6 ml serum liye hain. Ab serum kitna diluted ho gaya? Ten time diluted. Okay, ten time. Now, okay. ठीक है, ten time diluted है. ये मैं इसलिए बता रहा हूँ कि बहुत लोगों को confusion होता है. Ten time diluted. See, 5.4 है, 0.6 हमने लिया, ये total 6 हो गया. तो 10 टाइम डाइल्यूटेड है और इसका हम 3 ml ले रहे हैं तो ये भी 10 टाइम ही डाइल्यूटेड है. नेक्स्ट इज सो हाउ यू विल कैलकुलेट सीरम यूरिक एसिड मिलीग्राम परसेंट. यू हैव टू टेक द ओडी ऑफ टेस्ट माइनस ओडी ऑफ ब्लैंक. यूजुअली ब्लैंक जीरो आता है इसलिए उसको मेंशन नहीं किया है. तो ओडी ऑफ टेस्ट अपॉन ओडी ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड इनटू अमाउंट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड अपॉन वॉल्यूम ऑफ द सीरम. So tell me the amount of standard. Amount of standard batao. Chalo yahan de diya maine 1 mg/cent hai, amount of standard batao. Ye galtiyan exam mein tum karte ho isliye main bat kar raha hu. Amount of standard batao. Yes, किसी ने बोला 3 ml. अभिषेक सिंह, इट इज नॉट 3 ml, इट इज 0.03 mg. मैंने अमाउंट पूछा है. कीर्ति प्रजापति, यू आर राइट. वैभव काल राय, यू आर राइट. ठीक है, वो कैसे होगा मैं बता रहा हूं. सी अमाउंट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड वर्किंग स्टैंडर्ड 1 ग्राम वन मिलीग्राम परसेंट है, दैट इज नथिंग बट 1 mg पर 100 ml. सिंस 100 ml में 1 mg है, हेंस 3 ml में 1/100 × 3, 3 mg होगा. आई एम सॉरी, एक्चुअली ये ml ml कैंसिल हो जाएगा, ये हियर mg शुड बी देयर. सो 0.03 mg, दैट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड. सिमिलरली दूसरा फॉर्मूला में क्या है, वॉल्यूम ऑफ सीरम. वॉल्यूम ऑफ सीरम कितना होगा, टेल वॉल्यूम ऑफ सीरम. ये तो हो चुका है, वॉल्यूम ऑफ सीरम बताओ. मिनट, वॉल्यूम ऑफ सीरम शिवम कुमार, इट इज नॉट 0.6 ml. जोया अक्रम, यू राइट, 0.3 ml, 0.3 × 10, 10 टाइम डाइल्यूटेड है ना, 3/10 करने का. यस शिवम कुमार, नाउ यू आर राइट. तो ऐसे होता है, ये कभी गलती मत करना, वो कैलकुलेशन में तुम्हें वहां लास्ट टाइम प्रॉब्लम हो जाएगी. ओके, सो द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ सीरम कैसे, एज पी एफ एफ इज डाइल्यूटेड 10 टाइम्स, सो द वैल्यू ऑफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ सीरम इज 3/10, एज सिंपल एज इट इज. सो द फाइनल इक्वेशन इज ओडी अपॉन ओडी टेस्ट अपॉन ओडी स्टैंडर्ड इनटू 3/100 into 100, because हमें 100 ml. So whatever the amount you will get, that is the milligram percent, or you can say that much milligram per 100 ml. Over. So what are the precaution you have to take? Early morning sample should be taken. Avoid high purine diet. करना है because उससे ज़्यादा आ सकता है. Urine sample should be rapidly processed to avoid the bacterial degradation. As simple as that. स्टैंडर्ड प्रिकॉशन को पता है, हैंडलिंग में कैसे लेना है, जो आप अदर पे एक्सपेरिमेंट करते हो वही चीज. फर्दर इन्वेस्टिगेशन व्हाट यू विल डू, सपोज यू आर सस्पेक्टिंग ए केस ऑफ द एक्यूट गाउट और समथिंग लाइक दिस, तो 24 आवर यूरिन यूरिक एसिड तो करेंगे, साइनोवियल फ्लूइड एनालिसिस करेंगे, वहां से कैसे ऑर्थोसेंटेसिस करके फ्लूइड निकालेंगे, उसमें ल्यूकोसाइट काउंट बढ़े रहते हैं वो देखेंगे, सीरम क्रिएटिनिन देगा, बिकॉज इट इज मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम यूरेट डिपोजिशन ऑफ द यूरेट कैन लीड टू द यूरेट नेफ्रोपैथी. नेफ्रोपैथी होता तो केवल यूरेट ही थोड़े चीटर होगा, अगर नेफ्रोपैथी डेवलप हो गया तो क्रिएटिनिन भी बढ़ सकता है, उसमें भी प्रॉब्लम आ सकता है. फिर यू हैव टू नो द एग्जैक्ट साइट ऑफ द स्टोन, कहाँ पे है कहाँ नहीं है, तो रेडियोग्राफी से आप सीटी कराओ, सो दैट यू विल गेट द सीटी विद द हेल्प ऑफ सीटी, यू विल गेट द एग्जैक्ट लोकेशन ऑफ द यूरिनरी स्टोन. Anyway, in the case of the tophi also, if it is in the first metatarsophalangeal joint or whatever the knee joint mein nahi hota hai, jyadatar first metatarsophalangeal. So with the help of the CT and ultrasound, you can rule out. So this is the case we started with this today, discussing with this case only. So it is clear that it is a case of there is a history of the alcohol. So isse ye precipitate hua hai. Here the redness is there. Okay. So this is somewhere suggestive of acute gout. Here what you will do, you have to give the NSAID aur ghar bhej doge patient ko, baad mein uric acid karaoge, uske anusar se agar zyada rahega amount to other drugs pe sochoge. If it is chronic or acute, chronic on acute presentation aise bhi ho sakta hai ki koi chronic case ho, abhi acute se present kiya, so first you have to give NSAID, then you have to switch into the other drugs like that as per the clinical evidence, other drugs like fluoxetine. Okay, can you tell what is this case? One more case I have. This case ko batao kya hai. A 9-year-old boy presented with the pediatric emergency with history of severe nausea, vomiting, generalized weakness along with the twitching of the neck muscle from last 2 days. On further detailing, clinician knew that boy is newly diagnosed case of the acute lymphoblastic leukemia. For that, he is on a steroid from last 3 days. On examination, signs of the dehydration were there, and ECG suggestive of the arrhythmogenic pattern. For that, medication is started, and boy shifted to the ICU. Blood investigation show hyper फॉस्फेटेमिया है उसको, हाइपोकैल्सीमिया है, हाइपरकैलेमिया है along with the mild alteration in the CBC and LFT. What you are suspecting? ये पहले मैंने लिंक के साथ ही एक दे दिया था, अब बताओ. मॉर्निंग सैंपल इज जस्ट फॉर द कन बिकॉज माइट बी, अगर कुछ खा के आया तो कुछ कोई तो चीज प्यूरिन रिच हो ही सकती है ना. सो फॉर द कन्वीनियंस दे यूज टू गिव लाइक इंस्ट्रक्शन लाइक कम टू द मॉर्निंग सैंपल और नथिंग लाइक दैट. Amisha, now tell what is the diagnosis of this case? कुछ बताओ, अगर डायग्नोसिस नहीं बता पाते कुछ भी बताओ, इसमें हो क्या रहा है, मैंने ये केस क्यों दिया है. हाइपो पैराथायरॉइडिज्म कृति प्रजापति कैसे, हाउ हाइपोथायराइड क्रोनिक गाउट विद द रीनल नेफ्रोपैथी. क्रोनिक गाउट विद रीनल, इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. हाइपो पैराथायरॉइडिज्म इज नॉट आंसर. आई हैव गिवन वन केस हाइपोकैल्सीमिया. Hypocalcemia is one of the feature, even I have mentioned it, but how it is a diagnosis? We are here studying uric acid metabolism and its disorder, like the practical on the hyperuricemia. So something definitely is related to the hyperuricemia. Okay, anybody else? Secondary hyperuricemia, of course it is secondary hyperuricemia, but what is that case? Increased turnover, secondary gout. How in turnover increased here? कैसे? ल्यूकेमिया, केमोथेरेपी, गुड. एंटी कैंसर ड्रग, गुड. वैभव कारड़ा, खुशी एंड यश, यस, बिकॉज ऑफ ल्यूकेमिया, यस. तो सी, बट द डायग्नोसिस इज जस्ट नॉट ल्यूकेमिया एंड हाइपर सेकेंडरी हाइपरयूरेसिमिया. दिस कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड ट्यूमर लाइसिस सिंड्रोम. ओके, इसको बोलते हैं ट्यूमर लाइसिस सिंड्रोम. ट्यूमर लाइसिस सिंड्रोम में होता क्या है कि सपोज किसी को ल्यूकेमिया है या कुछ और प्रॉब्लम है, लिम्फोमा है, तो उसको हम ट्रीट करेंगे, केमोथेरेपी देंगे. हियर एस्टेरॉइड इज एक्टिंग लाइक द केमोथेरेपी, इसको हम सेल को डिस्ट्रॉय करेंगे. इफ द सेल विल गेट डिस्ट्रॉय तो क्या होगा, डीएनए डिस्ट्रॉय होगा. डीएनए डिस्ट्रॉय, उसमें क्या फॉस्फोडाइस्टर था, फॉस्फेट वगैरह निकलेगा, तो हाइपो हो जाएगा. यू कैन सी हियर अगेन प्यूरिन डिग्रेडेशन एंड आल्सो यूरिक एसिड बढ़ जाए, हाइपरयूरिसीमिया हो जाए, जिसको मैंने लिखा नहीं. एनीवे, इंट्रासेलुलर क्या रहता है, पोटेशियम रहता है. अब सेल खत्म हो रहे हैं, सेल मर रहे हैं, तो हाइपरकैलेमिया हो जाएगा. और हाइपरकैलेमिया कैन लीड टू व्हाट, चेंज इन द एसीजी. दैट्स व्हाई द पेशेंट प्रेजेंटेड विद द चेंज इन द एरिथमोजेनिक पैटर्न इन द एसीजी. इसलिए उसको आईसीयू में शिफ्ट कर दिया, क्योंकि ये क्रिटिकल कंडीशन है. हाइपरकैलेमिया तो उसको इंटेंसिव केयर मांगता है, अदरवाइज कार्डियक अरेस्ट हो जाएगा. ठीक है, ओके. एंड हाइपोकैल्सीमिया, क्योंकि फास्फेट बढ़ रहा है तो फास्फेट और कैल्शियम का ऐसे रहता है, तो हाइपोकैल्सीमिया होगा. बिकॉज ऑफ द हाइपोकैल्सीमिया, व्हिच क्लिनिकल फीचर इज सजेस्टिव, ट्विचिंग ऑफ द नेक मसल. ओके, ट्विचिंग ऑफ द नेक मसल हो रहा है. Nausea, vomiting is the general constitutive feature because of the increased uric acid and other factors are like the hyperkalemia. Generalized weakness, twitching of neck muscle because of the hypocalcemia. Or further detailing, jab usse liya gaya, to it was a case of the leukemia. Usually presentation is 9 year, 1 to 9 year old पीडियाट्रिक ग्रुप में ही होता है, छोटे बच्चों में होता है, जिसे हम एक्यूट लिम्फोब्लास्टिक ल्यूकेमिया होता है बोलते हैं, जिसे हम स्टेरॉयड देके ट्रीट करने की कोशिश की। सो उसके बाद से ये प्रेजेंट किया हाइपरफॉस्फेटेमिया, हाइपोकैल्सिमिया एंड हाइपरकैलेमिया से। सो व्हाट वी नीड टू डू, वी जस्ट मॉनिटर दिस हाउ मच अमाउंट वी कैन गिव एंड वी जस्ट टेक केयर ऑफ दिस पैरामीटर्स ऑल्सो, कि अगर सोडियम पोटेशियम ज्यादा तो नहीं हो रहा है, सो दैट इसलिए हम उस ड्रॉप को एडजस्ट करते हैं उसके डोज को। सो दिस इज कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड ट्यूमर लाइसिस सिंड्रोम। ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द टुडे क्लास, टुडे प्रैक्टिकल। इतना जरूर पता होना चाहिए क्या किस कंडीशन में बढ़ता है, किस कंडीशन में कम होता है, यूरिक एसिड का नॉर्मल फंक्शन क्या है, डाइप्रोटिक फॉर्म में एग्जिस्ट करता है, इसका क्या इंपॉर्टेंस है। निगेटिव मोनोसोडियम यूरेट होगा तो वो निगेटिव पाइप्रिजेंट क्रिस्टल बोलते हैं, अगर पॉजिटिव हुआ तो कैल्शियम पाइरोफॉस्फेट के कारण हुआ, तो ये उस जिसे हम सूडो गाउट बोलते हैं। इतना जानना है, इससे ज्यादा नहीं। और इसके साथ ही हम ये बुलेटिन खत्म करते हैं। बात हो तो पूछो, ट्विचिंग ऑफ नेक मसल क्यों, हाइपोकैल्सिमिया बता दिया। कैन यू रिपीट व्हाई देयर इज हाइपोकैल्सिमिया? सी फॉस्फेट एंड कैल्शियम इज एसोसिएटेड विद लाइक दे हैव द एंटागोनिस्ट, if the phosphate is increased calcium definitely will get down, okay? Yes Mithun, so it's the hypocalcemia and this is a question in the competitive exam they used to ask in tumor lysis which will be not seen, so hypocalcium sab de dega, hyperphosphatemia, hyperkalemia, hypercalcemia, it's a hypercalcemia you can will not hypocalcemia because of looking arrhythmia, ठीक है, एरिथमिया तो बिकॉज ऑफ द इंक्रीज पोटेशियम, इंक्रीज पोटेशियम विच काइंड ऑफ द ईसीजी चेंजेस वी विल सी, वी विल रीड इन द सेकंड ईयर मैकेनिकल क्वेश्चन, अभी जरूरत नहीं है इसमें नहीं। एनीथिंग एल्स, ओके just find out, okay, thank you. हाइपरफॉस्फेटेमिया, आई टोल्ड यू सेल डैमेज हो रहे हैं, डीएनए डैमेज हो रहा है, फॉस्फोडाइस्टर वहां बाउंड है तो फॉस्फेट कहाँ जाएगा, हाइपरफॉस्फेटेमिया तो होगा ही ना, एज सिंपल है। आई थिंक यू नाउ इट इज क्लियर, टॉपोलॉव। Okay, thank you.